each and every one of you. You're looking marvelous. And we're excited because today two become one. But before we continue, I need to ask you very kindly, and these were the words I was asked to give you, that you become unplugged.
Okay, amen.
All right, y'all know what unplugged is, right? All right, so unplug it. No cameras or no video or nothing like that other than what has been contracted to do, and we appreciate your sweetness in doing those things. And also, would you just do a double check that your cell phones are off so that it will not disturb the beauty of the moment.
Amen.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Thank you.
let us stand. Dearly beloved, we have come together here in the sight of God, in the presence of all these witnesses, to unite this man and woman in holy matrimony, which is a worthy institution proclaimed by God from the beginning of time. This ceremony signifies the great union which is between Christ and his church. Christ beautified the ceremony with his presence during the wedding of Cana of Galilee, where he performed the first miracle. And St. Paul commended marriage as a sacred institution which all persons should embrace, and therefore is not to be entered into lightly, but to be taken seriously, realizing that this ceremony is ordained of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined as one. Therefore, if anyone can show a just cause why they should not be united as husband and wife, let them speak now, or forever hold your peace. Hearing no objection, let the people of faith say amen.
Amen.
So I require and charge you both, as you must give an account at the time of God's judgment, that if either of you know any reason why you should not be legally united in holy matrimony, you do now confess. For be assured that if you are joined together in a manner that is not approved of God, your marriage is not lawful in his eyesight. And who gives the bride away?
Mother and I.
Amen. Won't you come? And thank you, sir. It's up to you. Okay. Okay. James, will you take Natasha to be your wedded wife, to live together according to God's laws in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, respect and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, your response is, I will.
I will.
And Natasha, will you take James to be your wedded husband, to live according to God's laws in this holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, respect and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself faithful to him as long you both shall live? If that is your desire, your answer is, I will.
I will.
And now, James, I want you to take her right hand. You just take her right hand, all right? Don't worry about that. I want you to look her eyeball to eyeball. And I want you to repeat after me. I, James, take you, Natasha, to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And thus I pledge you.
And thus I pledge you.
My faithfulness.
My faithfulness.
Amen. You let go of her hand. Now I want you to grab his right hand. Your right hand's fine. That's okay. Yeah, we good. That's okay. Use your right hand. Okay, there you go. I want you again to look at him eyeball to eyeball. There you go. I, Natasha. Take you, James. To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And thus I pledge you.
And thus I pledge you.
My faithfulness.
My faithfulness.
Let us bow our heads and let us talk to our faithful God. O eternal God, creator, preserver of all humankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send your blessings upon these, your servants, this man and this woman, whom we bless in your name, that as Isaac and Rebekah live faithfully together, so this couple may surely perform and keep the vows and covenant which they have made together. And may they ever remain in perfect love and peace together and live according to your laws through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And now Reverend Johnson will come and perform our ring ceremony. Do you have the rings? May I have the rings? Thank you. Thank you.
Bless the Lord, these rings. Bless him who gives, and bless her who wears. And bless her who gives, and bless him who wears. That they may live together in love and harmony through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Have small hands. Hey, will you repeat after me? With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed you and I endow you.
I wed you and I endow you.
With my worldly possessions.
With my worldly possessions.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Ooh. My Lord.
With this ring, we'll repeat after
me,
sorry. With this ring, I wed you.
With this ring, I wed you.
And I endow you.
And I endow you.
With my worldly possessions.
With my worldly possessions.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. There we go, baby. It's on. Mm-hmm. There we go. There we go.
They get sick here.
Yeah, I got it, buddy.
At this time, the couple has chosen to participate in a sand ceremony, which symbolizes the joining of two families.
That's right.
And when we talk about endless love, there's no greater love than the one who has no beginning or no end, and that is God.
Amen.
So together, will you bow your head and let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
James and Natasha, we didn't come just for a ceremony. We came to witness a marriage.
Say it, preacher.
A marriage where two miraculously can become one. Now, you made some vows in the presence of these people, but more importantly, in the presence of God, that you're going to love one another. Now, may I give you some real talk?
All right.
You didn't come because you're always going to like one another. There are going to be some things that he does you just ain't going to like.
Right.
There'll be some things she does you ain't going to like. But that's because you all are two different individuals. And now two are becoming one, not because you like one another, but because you love one another. And love is what's going to make the difference. So when you have those arguments, you have those disagreements, those different points of views, remember, love is going to be the glue that keeps you as one. So just remember a little ditty that I heard a long time ago. And simply is this: a house is made of brick and stone, but a home is made of love alone. May the love of God always be welcome in your home, and may love always abide in your hearts. And if I have some people to agree, just say amen.
Amen.
Those whom God has joined together, let no person put asunder. For as much as James and Natasha have consented to live together in holy matrimony and have borne witness to this before God and you, they've pledged their faith to one another by joining hands and giving and receiving of rings. Henceforth, it is my happy privilege to now pronounce you husband and wife together in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Now, before we get to the part y'all waiting for, okay, let's get to it. You may kiss your bride. And now, to really try to tie the knot closely, one more time, I ask you to bow your head and let's ask God's blessings to rest upon them. Almighty God, who at the beginning of time did create our first parents, Adam and Eve, and did sanctify and join them together in marriage, pour upon this couple the riches of your grace. Sanctify and bless them, and may they please you in body and soul, and live together in love until the end of their lives, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
And so it's my happy privilege for the first time to present to you,
all right,
Mr. and Mrs. James and Natasha Jordan.
James. That's my favorite James.